Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you 10 things you may not know your Mac can do. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 700 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So here are 10 things that I know a lot of Mac users don't know they can do on their Mac. Let's see how many you already know about and what's new to you. So first is the character chooser. Ever want to use an emoji or a special symbol but don't know how to find it? Well, it's really easy. When you're typing text anywhere, whether it's in an email, in a web form, a word processor, or even just here in TextEdit, all you have to do is press Control Command Space and it brings up the character chooser. And here you could see from a huge list of all the emoji and special symbols that you could add in with text. But you don't have to go and search through everything to find what you want. Just use the search field here at the top. So type something like happy, for instance, and you'll get a bunch of emoji that have to do with happy. If you're looking for some sort of symbol, just type something that has to do with that symbol. Did you know you could batch rename files in the Finder? So here I have a bunch of image files. I'm going to use Command A to select them all. And then when I go to File, Rename, you can see it's rename 18 items. So I can select that and then I have a whole variety of different things I can choose. For instance, I can choose to replace text. So I can replace that IMG underscore here with the word photo followed by a space, hit rename, and it renames all of those. A quick Command Z to undo, and I could try something else. Like for instance, I could rename them all with a special format. So I can use the word picture with numbers starting at 1 after the name and hit rename, and you can see now it renames the whole group. When using apps like Pages, Numbers, Keynote, and some third-party apps, you have something called versions where you can revert to previous versions of a file. So let's say I was working on this file here and I deleted a paragraph, maybe on purpose, maybe by mistake, and then I saved, Command S. If I go to File, Revert To, I can choose Browse All Versions and it will take me into this interface here. It looks a lot like Time Machine. I can go to the previous version of the file and you could see there's that missing paragraph. I can hit Restore to restore it to that version, but I could also click in here and select text out of it, copy, and paste somewhere else or into the current version if I want. You can go back more than just one version to it. You can go back to previous days, weeks, months, and find something that you may have deleted or changed and get it back. Now you may know a lot of keyboard shortcuts and different ways to use your trackpad or mouse, but there's also something called hot corners where you can assign a function to simply moving your cursor up to the corner of a screen. You can find this by going into System Preferences, then go to Mission Control. Then in here, click on the Hot Corners button. And you can see there are four corners here and you can assign a function to each one of them. So for instance, you can have Launchpad launch when you go to the upper left-hand corner, or the bottom right-hand corner can instantly lock the screen when you move the cursor there. You can also add modifier keys. So if you want to use lock screen for the bottom right hand corner but only when holding the command key down, just hold the command key down when selecting it. And you can see now it requires the command key to be held down when you move your cursor to the bottom right to activate that function. Now if sometimes you'd rather not type but be able to dictate text using the microphone on your Mac, you can do that one of two ways. Let me show you the simplest. You can go to System Preferences and then under Keyboard go to Dictation. And make sure Dictation is turned on. Then check your keyboard shortcut. In this case, it's pressing the FN key twice. So now to dictate into this TextEdit document, I'll just press FN twice and talk. The quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. Period. You could also do the opposite and get your Mac to read text to you. You can select text in a document like this, or select text in Safari or an email. Then just go to Edit, Speech, and Start Speaking.
The quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog.
You could set up options for that in System Preferences, Accessibility, Speech, and you can change the voice and the speaking rate. Another interesting thing you can do is have your Mac summarize text for you. So if you have a large block of text like this you need to read, you could try selecting the text and then go to the Application menu here, go to Services, and look for Summarize. This brings up a special application hidden on your Mac called Summary, and here you can drag this slider all the way to the right. It's just going to have the text as is. But if you move it to the left more, it's going to try to pick out what's important in the text to try to summarize it for you. So if this is about the length of what you want to read, you could try reading this. It's not perfect. Sometimes it helps you get the important information if you're really limited on time. Now the calculator app is a handy way to do quick calculations. You can click on these with your cursor or you can actually use the keys on the keyboard and get the answer. But a lot of people don't know there's also a paper tape window. You can get to it with Command T. And this gives you a rundown of all your calculations. So as you do more calculations, it'll keep adding it to the tape. You can select text in here and copy and paste it. You could also print the tape or save the tape as, and it'll save it as a text document. Now if you do use the calculator app, you may be interested to know there's an easier way to perform calculations most of the time. And that's to use Spotlight. So you can use Command Space to bring up Spotlight and then type equations, simple things like this, but you could also use parentheses, something you can't really do with a calculator app very easily. And get results like that. There are even functions available like that or that. Now another option, of course, is just to use Siri for calculations. 2,874 divided by 3.
It's 958.
Now if you're sick of going to news sites and seeing web pages like this with tons of ads and other content on them, you can use Reader View in Safari just to see the text and images that have to do with the article. Just look for this icon up here. Click that and it goes into Reader View. You can also use Shift Command R to enter and exit Reader View. And here you can see a much nicer version of an article. You could also click here when in Reader View and adjust it to make it even easier to read. So you know when I do lists like this, I like to include a bonus one at the end. So you know when you have really small text at a web page or in an email and you want to be able to zoom in to read it? Well, you can do just that. If you go to System Preferences and then Accessibility and then click on Zoom, you have your controls for zooming. You can set it any way you want. I've got it set to use the trackpad to scroll, so two fingers on the trackpad, with the Option and Command keys held down. And I have it set to zoom in picture in picture. So if I want to read this text here, all I need to do is put my cursor near it. I'm going to hold the Option and Command keys down just like I have specified here and then use two fingers to zoom in with my trackpad. And now you can see I get this box. I don't have to keep holding those keys. I can just move this box around now and see different things on the screen. And I can Option, Command, and scroll down until it's gone. I can also set it to zoom full screen or split screen if I want and change tons of different options. Now if I want to just see the text, I can enable hover text right here in Catalina and hold the Command key down whenever I'm over text. So for instance, I could just hold the Command key down here and you can see it brings up the text there in a separate box. And it happens anywhere. So there are tons of other hidden functions in macOS, but these are the ones that I thought were the most useful by the most people. But let me know in the comments below if there are other hidden functions in particular that you like and want to share them with others. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.